بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته عبد الله servant of God المبارك the blessed one المسيح the Messiah كلمة الله the word of God روح الله spirit from God النبي the prophet الرسول the messenger ابن مريم daughter of Mary. These are some of the names in the Quran given to one of the greatest servants of the Almighty, Prophet Jesus, Isa alayhi salam. He is very much revered and respected in the religion of Islam, mentioned 25 times in the Holy Quran across 13 different chapters. As Muslims, we are encouraged to learn from him and take him as an exemplary role model. As many in the world are celebrating the occasion of his birth, here are 10 beautiful words of wisdom from Prophet Jesus alayhi salam, extracted from the hadith of the Holy Prophet Muhammad and his Ahlul Bayt, peace and blessings be upon them all. Number one, watch your tongue. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is reported to have said, the Masih used to say, he who often becomes upset, his body becomes sick. He whose character is bad, his self becomes his torment. He who often talks, often stumbles. He who often lies, he loses his worth. He who quarrels with men loses his manliness. It's easy to forget to watch what we say and utter daily. In environments where people are encouraged to talk and sometimes lie, a believer should not just follow the trend, but be very much cognizant of every word uttered and understand the grave dangers of lying and deception. Because hadith tells us that lying is the keys for the house of evil deeds. Number two, identify your priorities. Prophet Isa alayhi salam famously said, who would build a house on the waves of the sea? This world is that house, so you should not take it as a dwelling. This great prophet makes a statement worthy of reflection. In this world, people invest in businesses, stocks, and other matters. They would not invest or build something that would not last or is likely to fail. We are encouraged not to forget our akhirah by investing only in this world. This means we work hard to achieve success in the hereafter more than working hard to achieve success here, by ensuring we do good and avoid wrong according to God's instructions. Let's ask ourselves each and every single day, what have we offered for the next life? In another narration, Prophet Isa alayhi salam said, do not take the world as a master, for it will take you as its servants. Number three, don't destroy your good deeds. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, famously said, how many lamps the wind has put out and how many worshippers' pride has corrupted. It was the major sin that destroyed Satan, and he will work to drag as many as possible through it. We are mortal servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we must never believe or feel we have done enough to attain his pleasure. This should remain our focus all the time, until we meet him. Unfortunately, the self-conceit of some individuals have truly corrupted their ibadah or their worship. Number four, don't overeat. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, said, do not be excessive in eating, for those who are excessive in eating are excessive in sleeping, and those who are excessive in sleeping are deficient in praying, and those who are deficient in praying, it is written that they are negligent. One thing leads to another, Prophet Isa alayhi salam is saying, the body is connected to the soul. Overeating and too much sleeping damages the soul. The damaged soul cannot function properly and hence won't be able to fulfill its objectives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the body and the soul, and he instructs us to have moderation in eating and sleeping, for he knows best what is good for us. Number five, protect people from yourself. It is reported that Imam Ali alayhi salam said, Jesus, the son of Mary, peace be upon him, said, blessed is he who silences contemplation, fikr, whose vision is an admonition, whose house suffices him, and who cries over his mistakes, and from whose hand and tongue the people are safe. A key feature of a successful believer, my dear sisters and brothers, is how they interact with people in society and how he or she becomes a source of comfort and support rather than a wrath or harm towards others. In the world of social media, we may forget that the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching every post, forward or like, and that we will be held accountable for them. That there is no doubt. Number 6, choose your friends wisely. It is reported that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the apostles said to Jesus, O Spirit of Allah, with whom should we keep company? He replied, the sight of whom reminds you of Allah, the speech of whom increases your knowledge, and the works of whom makes you desirous of the other world, the Akhirah. It is mentioned in Islamic teachings that if we don't know an individual, we would get to have a good idea of who they are when we identify their friends. The Quran tells us that all friends will be enemies on the Day of Judgment, except those who have based their friendship on God consciousness, taqwa. Let's not forget how friends play a key role in our spiritual growth by being sources of enlightenment and advice. The correct friends, of course. Number 7, parents, the path to paradise. A man once said to Isa alayhi salam, O good teacher, indicate to me a work by which I may enter Jannah. Isa said to him, beware of Allah secretly and openly, and do good to your parents. According to Islamic teachings, parents have much rights over their children. They should be respected, honored, and prayed for as much as possible. Note the feeling that some may have in this day and age, where they use the excuse that parents are old-fashioned or not modern to disrespect or belittle their parents. Not only does paradise lie under the feet of the mother, but according to a narration, one of the gates of Jannah is the father. We must not forget this important key feature in our teachings. Number 8, the blessed livelihood. It is narrated that Prophet Isa alayhi salam said to a worshipper, what do you do? That in man replied, I worship. Jesus said to him, then who provides for you? The man replied, my brother. Isa alayhi salam said, your brother is more of a worshipper than you are. You see, monasticism was not the practice of God's emissaries, such as Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. They were involved with people and did not abandon creation. Similarly, Islam states that a major part of worship of God is seeking legitimate sustenance, rizq, obtained through hard work and without the disobedience of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number 9, serve and serve. Prophet Jesus alayhi salam passed by a grave whose occupant was being chastised. Then he passed it the following year and he realized that the person in the grave was not being punished. He said, oh Lord, I passed through this town last year and he was being punished, and now I pass through it and he's not being punished. Allah revealed to him, O Ruhullah, verily, one of his children matured and cleared some way and sheltered an orphan. Therefore, I forgave him for the deeds of his child. How beautiful. My dear sisters and brothers, is the idea of upbringing our children to serve and make a positive contribution in society. For that, parents need to lead by example and do good deeds themselves. This would then encourage ongoing charity, sadaqah jariyah, resulting in continuous reward till the day of Qiyamah, judgment. Finally, number 10, beware of falling into traps. Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, is reported to have said, verily, Moses, the Prophet of Allah, commanded you not to commit adultery, and I command you not to talk to yourselves about adultery, let alone to commit adultery. Verily, one who talks to himself about adultery is like the one who sets fire to a room that is decorated so the smoke damages the decor, even though the room is not burnt. Today, we are bombarded by indecent images, clips on the internet, TV, billboards, etc. Through these, the shaitan plants seeds of lust and desire, dragging people closer and closer to major sins such as fornication and adultery. These are called triggers, and we must be wary of them when surfing the net or watching TV. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is reported to have said, Isa alayhi salam said, beware of looking at that which is prohibited, for it is the seed that plants lust and indeed deprives the human being. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we can instill these values taught to us by Prophet Isa alayhi salam through the words of the Ahlul Bayt into our lives. And we pray that we live to meet this great Prophet of God, who of course will pray behind the Savior of mankind, Imam al-Mahdi. May Allah hasten his reappearance.